So it's not a lie, it's just a habit. But that woman is never going to be okay. Because her full-time focus is what's wrong. Let's give her a nickname so we know who she is. Let's give her a name. Who is she? That woman. Maybe a nickname you don't like or that would make you laugh because it's so stupid.
Let her get her own name. It's okay. She can do it.
Maybe...
What would you give to a name that's negative, like Eeyore-like? Somebody's like, everything, the sky is falling, it's horrible. What's the name of a person like that? Who lives in their head?
Chicken Little.
I don't know. Foolish.
What is it? Foolish? The foolish one.
Yes.
Okay, there's the foolish one. I want to meet a different part of you. I'm going to meet the crazy bitch. I want you to walk back there, and I want you... And I want you to walk up here like a crazy bitch. Yes. Throw a hook. Listen to me. I know you can understand me, even though the language varies a little bit. You're doing a really good job. I don't need to do this with you. I'm behind on time. I want to help you if you want to be helped. But I can only fucking help you if you do what I tell you to fucking do. If you do it half-assed, it's not going to do anything. You either fucking step up or go back to being depressed. I'm okay with you doing it. I'd love to help you, but it's your choice. I'm not going to make you do it.
Tall and thin and young and lovely, the girl from the end.
if you can identify with the happy crazy bitch, look at me, look at the face when I say happy crazy bitch. All you're gonna do is call happy crazy bitch and she's smiling. Right? Guys are like, I didn't think that would work. Notice, smiling and laughing will fuck up all your depression, so don't do that. Don't be smiling and laughing, or pretty soon you'll be a happy human being, even though they've robbed some money from there, even though politicians have done stupid things, even though you've lost a sister, which is painful for anyone, I get it. I'm not denying that. I'm just saying, would she want you to be miserable? Is that the way she'd be? Would she feel honored by you being miserable?
No.
What would be her highest wish if you were going to honor her? What would she want you to be?
I guess she wants all of us to be happy.
Yes. And why?
She was such a good person.
Yes. So maybe the greatest gift, if you want to truly honor her, is not this, but what you just did here and what you're doing right now. And it's okay to have a tear in there because you love her. But it's even more beautiful when you can breathe her into your heart and soul and remember she has not left you, she's in you. Yes. That's painful, it's also beautiful, isn't it? It's not beautiful to have her inside you. It's not beautiful for her to want you to be happy, for your whole family to be happy. Is that beautiful or ugly?
It's beautiful.
And the woman who walked down this aisle was a little crazy and a little fun and quite beautiful. How many thought she was beautiful? For all of us, we are never depressed or angry or sad at the facts. We're angry with our perception of the facts. She doesn't think her sister should have died. Who are we to say what God's plan is or the universe if you don't believe in God? Perhaps her dying is a chance for you to rise up. Maybe it's a call to you to stop living in the dirt and raise up into your heart and lead your family with love. Maybe it's time to stop thinking about your loss and focus on others in love and bring them the love they desperately need. Maybe it's time to channel your beautiful sister to your heart because she lives in you. Can you feel it? Yes. So maybe from this day forward, there'll be times of tears, but maybe there can be fewer times of tears. And maybe there can be more joyful times. Because the only reason we're sad is we're focused on our loss less never. How many see this right now? As opposed to appreciating what we do have, loving what we do have control over, what we can influence even if we can't control it, and trusting in a higher power that there's a higher purpose. How many of you have had something happen 5, 10, 15 years ago that was so painful you would never want anyone to go through it, much less you again? How many have had an experience like this? And yet, how many of you 5, 10, 15 years later now look back and say, I never want to go through it, but I'm glad we did because it made me care so much more. It made me so much more driven. It made me so much more compassionate. It made me stronger. Who here has found the meaning? Say, ah. Stop living in the past. There's nothing for you there. You have to come back to this moment, to the joy of this moment, because while that heart beats inside you, there is hope, there is possibility, there is love, there is energy, and you were just grinning from ear to ear, and all you did is go back to the old pattern. Snap out of it. How fast? There you go, just like that.